There are three mechanisms in SPIN to create protection domains and use them. The first one is, of course, the create call that allows creating a logical protection domain. And this mechanism in SPIN allows initiating an object file with the contents and export the names that are contained as entry point methods inside the object to be visible outside. That's what this create call supported by SPIN provides to a service creator. For example, if I am creating a memory management service, I can write the entry point functions in my memory management service and export the names using this create mechanism that's available in SPIN. The second mechanism in SPIN is resolving names. If one protection domain wants to use the names that is there in another protection domain, the way it can accomplish that is by using this resolve primitive that's available in SPIN. Resolve is very similar to linking two separately compiled files together that a compiler does routinely. So you may be very familiar with the compilation process where you may separately compile files, and once you have done the separate compilation of the files, then you go through a link phase of the compiler where the linker resolves the names that are being used by one object file with the names that are defined in another object file. That's the same thing that the resolve mechanism of SPIN does, is it resolves the names that are being used in source, which is a logical protection domain, and the target, which is another logical protection domain. As a result of this resolve step, the source logical protection domain and the target logical protection domain are dynamically linked or bound together. And once bound together, accessing methods that are inside this target protection domain happens at memory speeds, meaning it is as efficient as a procedure call once this resolve step has happened. As I mentioned before, to reduce the proliferation of small logical protection domains, you may want to combine protection domains to create an aggregate larger protection domain, and SPIN provides a mechanism for that, which is the combine mechanism. Once the names in a source and target logical protection domain have been resolved, they can be combined to create an aggregate domain, and the aggregate logical protection domain will have entry points, which is the union of the entry points that were exported as names from the source and the target, or any number of such domains that have been combined together to create an aggregate domain. So this combine primitive in SPIN is mainly useful as a software engineering management tool to combat the proliferation of many small domains. So once again, the roadmap for creating services is: write your code as a modular 3 program with well-defined entry points, and using the SPIN mechanism of create, you can instantiate a service and export the names that are available in that service. And if another logical protection domain wants to use the names that are exported, it can do so by using the SPIN mechanism resolve that causes the dynamic binding of the source and target logical protection domains. And finally, the combine primitive allows aggregation of logical protection domains to create an aggregate domain that's the union of all the entry points that are available in the component logical protection domains. This is it. This is the secret sauce in SPIN to get protection and performance while allowing flexibility. Everything hinges on the strongly typed nature of the programming language that is being used for implementing the operating system. That is, the language allows compile time checking and runtime enforcement of the logical protection domains. That's the key to the success of this approach to providing flexibility, protection, and performance all in one bag.